Hello everyone, welcome to Morning English. This is January.
Hello everybody, this is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Nora, since it's close to the end of 2020, is there anything you want to accomplish before the end of this year?
2020年马上就要接近尾声了，你还有哪些想要完成的事情呢？
I really want to go travel. I haven't been anywhere this year because of the coronavirus and quarantine.
Yeah, I see. So, have you made any travel plans yet?
Yeah, I'm planning to travel to the northeast.
今年年底啊，打算去东北玩。
Sounds like you're going to have a frozen vacation.
Hope it won't be that cold, but I'm really excited to see the snow.
Yeah, it must be really beautiful there.
So Jen, what about you? Is there anything you want to do before the end of 2020?
Well, you know, I'm a huge fan of sports, so I really want to watch the Olympic Games. I was really looking forward to it.
我也是，就是2020年的东京奥运会，是不是？
Mm-hmm.
本来大家都很期待的，但是今年是看不到了。
Yeah, it has been postponed due to the coronavirus.那东京奥运会呢，也是因为疫情的原因被推迟到了明年。But speaking of Olympics, what's the most unforgettable memory from the Olympic Games that you've watched?
那我看奥运会印象最深刻的呀，那应该算是2004年雅典奥运会刘翔夺冠的那一刻吧。
Yeah, I remember that. He even broke the Olympic record.
是的，一般我们看体育赛事嘛，目光永远追随的都是最快最强的那一个运动员。
那其实呢还有一名游泳运动员，他也打破了奥运会记录。不过他打破的是男子100米自由泳最慢记录，但是呢他却赢得了人们的尊重。
那我们今天这期节目呢就一起来了解一下这位史上最慢的游泳运动员。
So what's the name of this swimmer?
Eric Musavani, and he actually got a nickname.
What is it?
Well, he was nicknamed Eric the Eel by the media.
Eel?那就是鳗鱼的意思吗? I guess maybe it's because of the way he swims.
Yeah, probably. Also, Eric, Eel, all start with the letter E.
So, where is he from?
Well, he's from Equatorial Guinea.
Equatorial Guinea 就是赤道几内亚。赤道呢这个单词是 Equator. 它的形容词形式就是 Equatorial, 指的是赤道的。
Yeah, Equatorial Guinea is a country located on the west coast of Central Africa.
是的，赤道几内亚呢是一个非洲的中西部国家，长期以来啊被列入是世界最不发达的国家名单。
Although it has become one of Africa's largest oil producers, the wealth is distributed extremely unevenly, with few people benefiting from the oil riches.
是的，虽然之后啊他们发现了大量的石油资源，然后经济快速增长了。但是国民的总体经济收入仍然是处于贫困状态的。
是的。
那刚刚讲到一个单词 distribute 就是指的分布分配的意思。Uneven 表示不均匀的。So the wealth is distributed unevenly, 就是指的财富的分配不均匀。
是的，所以当地的整体经济条件都不是很好。那么 Eric, 他就是出现在一个当地最贫困的一个村庄里面。当时呢他在广播里面听到全国招募奥运游泳选手的消息，就马上去报名了，而且因为没有其他的人报名，然后他就被选上去了。
He's very lucky that he's the first swimmer to compete in the Olympics for Equatorial Guinea.
是的，他就成了赤道几内亚历史上第一位游泳运动员。
But here's the problem.
What?
He did not know how to swim.
那离参加奥运会啊只有四个月了，却还不会游泳。It must have been a nightmare.
Right, 所以就只能够现学。但是赤道几内亚全国没有一个标准游泳池，更难得找到一个游泳教练了。
So he had never seen an Olympic-sized swimming pool before the match day. So how did he learn to swim?
He had to train on his own and he had no swimming experience at all.
on his own 就是靠某人自己做某件事情啊，在不会游泳没有教练的情况下他的训练全靠他自己 And since there was no Olympic size swimming pool in the country So where did he train himself?
Well, he went to train at a private hotel pool that was about 13 meters long The pool was only available from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. And he was only able to train for 3 hours a week
Available 指的就是可以使用的那他也是找到了一家酒店顶楼上呢有一个13米长的小泳池一周可以来三次每次呢是一个小时而且是在日出前的5点到6点才可以训练
Yeah, and he used to go swimming in rivers and sea too The fishman would tell him how to use his legs and how to swim
But there was nothing professional about it at all
Exactly When he arrived at the 2000 Sydney GamesHe had only been training for the 100-meter freestyle for about 4 months. And he also had never been in an Olympic-sized pool before and had never raced more than 50 meters.
Regardless, he was determined to represent his country. 刚刚讲到这个 freestyle 其实就指的游泳里面的自由泳。那他参加100米的自由泳比赛嘛，在比赛之前他都没有游过超过50米。而且 Eric 比赛日他穿着的是最好的装备是一条从二手店买回来的宽松的大裤衩和一条发灰的毛巾
对然后一个南非教练就拦住了他 Then the coach gave him a swimming costume and goggles
Swimming costume 就是指的泳装了那 goggles 是我们游泳的时候戴的泳镜如果没有这些的话他真的可能就连比赛资格都会被取消
是的因为他的着装不符合比赛的规范那在正式比赛的时候呢也非常的戏剧化 When the officials called the swimmers to their marks Both of Eric's competitors were disqualified for full starts
刚刚这句话的意思呢就是在说两位对手因为抢跳被取消了参赛的资格 Disqualified 就是指的取消资格的意思 Full start 在体育比赛中呢就是表的抢跑抢跳的意思
Then left to swim by himself Eric dove in and dog paddled Gasping for air
那这个故事接下来发生了什么呢他就做了几个动作第一个是 paddle 就是滑的意思 dog paddle 就是指的狗刨式嘛然后 gasp for air 大口的呼气喘气所以 Eric 是游得非常艰难的
是的因为他之前都没有游过100米最多不超过50米而且啊甚至是在最后25米的时候他没有力气了双腿就是在水下就动弹不了只剩下半口气用两只手爬到了岸边
And when he finally pulled himself from the water, the applause thundered. 就是当他最终到达终点的时候啊，全场是掌声雷鸣。他的最终成绩呢是1分52秒72。
那么他这个成绩呢是创造了奥运会历史上最慢的记录，但是这个成绩却是赤道几内亚历史上最好的成绩。
这100米其实是一个勇士的征途了。
他的故事呢，其实就让我想到了现代奥林匹克之父顾拜旦的名言。The most important thing in the Olympic Games is not winning, but taking part. The essential thing in life is not conquering, but fighting well.
奥林匹克的精神也是在此，不是凯旋，而是战斗；不是胜利，而是参与。这也是可以通过他的事例，我们可以学到的精神。那今天我们的节目呢，就到这里结束了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Jen. See you next time. Bye.
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语就来早安英文。